So in political science, from this chapter some questions comes. Clear? And such type of, you know, facts you must have stored. Clear? In democracy, a better form of government when compared with dictatorship. Clear? So why democracy is better than dictatorship? Right? If they ask, why democracy is better than, clear? Better than dictatorship. Clear? Why? This question appears. Clear? And in 9th standard, you have studied it well. Clear? The very first reason is that it promotes equality among citizens. Right? Because first, promote equality. Clear? Among citizens. Clear? First part, it promotes equality among citizens. Understood? The very second is it enhances the dignity. Right? Enhances the dignity. The dignity of individual. Isn't it? It enhances dignity of individual. Any problem? Anyone? Any word? If you have difficulty, you may ask. Here, it enhances dignity. Dignity means self-respect and self-pride. Understand? That is enhanced, increased. Here, in democracy, it improves quality of decision making. Right? Improves quality of decision making. Clear? If 3 marks question it comes, then you have to write only this 3 points. And if it appears of 5 marks, you have to increase 2 more points. It provides a method to resolve conflict. Clear? Provide method to resolve conflict. Clear? And the very 5th point. Clear? It provide method to resolve conflict. Clear? Conflict means you can say improper opinion means if opinion clashes. Clear? That is conflict. When there is a clash of opinion. And last, it allows room to correct mistakes. Yes? It allows room to correct mistakes. Clear? Understood everyone? These 5 points you must keep in your mind. It may appear in your exam. What are you writing? What is this? Intelligent? You are intelligent. Good. What is this? Symptom of getting compartment. If you are not writing anything, it is symptom of getting less marks. Nobody will help you in examination room for long answers. Understand? So try to be careful. So here, all these expectations realized under democracy. because all these five expectations are realized. Understood? We realize all these expectations in democracy. Clear? And when we talk to people around us, most of them support democracy against other alternatives. Clear? Because democracy has no alternative. Clear? It is the only best form of government, clear, which is supported by all. And other alternatives can be rejected in front of this. Understand? We cannot accept any other alternative. Clear? So here, not so many of them would be satisfied with the democracy in practice, but still, some people, they are not satisfied with democracy. Clear? Why? Because in democracy, you have got some good principles, but they felt to be not so good in practice. Right? This dilemma invites them to think so. Because in democracy, corruption increases. Isn't it? There is no strict administration. It cannot provide strict administration. Isn't it? And there is, you can say, economic development is poor. Right? In democracy, there is less economic development in comparison to dictatorship government. Clear? And in democracy, there is lot of corruption. Clear? And in democracy, there is poor administration. That's why some people dislike it. Right? But still, it has a lot of benefits. Understand? That's why we have, accepted it. Problems are there in every system. Isn't it? But democratic system is the best system in which there are very less problems. Clear? Let our economy not increase. It may run. Isn't it? We will earn very small amount, doesn't matter. But it should give us all fundamental rights. Isn't it? We must be given freedom, liberty, equality before law, right to speech. Many types of rights are given in democracy. That's why it is better. Isn't it? In front of this, all problems are meaningless. Clear? It can be improved. So here we can say that, do we prefer democracy only for moral reasons? Yes. Again, or are there some prudential reasons to support democracy? So over 100 years, countries, right, of the world today claim and practice some kind of democratic politics. Clear? And they have formed contribution. Clear? Formal contribution is there and still we like it. So our interest and fascination for democracy often pushes us into taking a position that democracy can address all socio-economic and political problems. Clear? It can address every type of social problem, economic problem, political problem. It has capacity to solve. That's why we have accepted it. Clear? So imagine that other form of government may take decision very fast, but it may take decision which are not accepted by all. Suppose you have got dictatorship government, and it has capacity to take fast decision. They take quick decision. Clear? But will it help? Never. Because quick decisions means result comes very quickly, but it may be wrong decision. Isn't it? It may be a wrong decision. So after that means wrong decision nobody accept. Clear? So it happens in dictatorship. Clear? And we face problem. So democracy is based on the idea of deliberation and negotiation. Clear? Democracy is based on the idea of deliberation. Deliberation and negotiation, very important line. Clear? It is based on deliberation and negotiation. Deliberation means
वी डिलीवर आवर स्पीच, वी डिलीवर आवर व्यूज, वी कीप आवर व्यूज, एंड नेगोशिएशन मीन्स इन डेमोक्रेसी वी नेगोशिएट, वी टॉक विद ईच अदर, वी कंसल्ट एवरीवन, राइट, देन टेक्स डिसीजन. अंडरस्टूड? वी कैन नॉट टेक आवर यू नो सेल्फ डिसीजन इन डेमोक्रेसी. डिसीजन इज टेकन बाय पीपल ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ देयर इलेक्टेड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स. Their elected representatives take a decision, and these elected representatives, they comes from common people. They are representative of common people. That's why decisions are taken, and they have to consult with each other before taking decision. Understood? So democracy is based on the idea of deliberation and negotiation. In contrast, democratic government will take more time to follow procedures before arriving at a decision, right? In democracy, it takes a lot of time to decide a case. You have listened, you have already, you know, heard many types of decisions, many types of, you know, decisions related to various types of corrupt activities, scams, clear? They took 20 years for deciding case. The killer of, you know, Indira Gandhi, they were hanged after 20 years. Means decision was taken after 20 years. Just imagine, right? In similar manner, many types of cases, they runs more than 10 years, isn't it? So in democracy, decisions are taken very late, but they are correct. Understand? Here, there is no chance of innocent person to be punished. Understood? That's why these people's, you know, democracy is better for us. Understood? It reduces poverty and inequality also. Clear? In democracy, what happened in contrast, democratic government will take more time, right, to follow procedures, and but because it has followed procedures, so its decision may be correct because it has followed procedures. They have taken decision step by step. Clear? Means they have justified every step, then decision is made, so that at every step innocent person is justified. Clear? So that no innocent person get punishment. That's why in democracy decisions are taken step by step. Understood? So here outcomes of every democracy. Clear? There are outcomes. Clear? So we will say that government is, you know, every government, it is accountable, responsive, and legitimate. This is the first outcome. Clear? Every government is what? Accountable, outcome. Of democracy, if you ask. Clear? So in short, the first outcome will be government is accountable, clear, responsive, and legitimate. Clear? Legitimate. So every government is accountable. Understood? It is legitimate and responsible. Understood? Means these three points are 100% confirming democratic government. Clear? And second is economic outcome. We expect that democracy produce economic growth and development and reduce poverty and equality. Second outcome is, we expect economic growth. Clear? Economic growth to reduce poverty and inequality. Clear? This is our expectation from democratic government. Understood?
and that last one is social outcome. Clear? The social outcome is we expect democracy to accommodate the social diversity, right? This is called economic outcome, right? This is economic outcome. Clear? And third is social outcome. Social outcome, right? It should resolve social differences and conflict. Clear? Understood? It should reduce social differences and conflict. This is the, you know, social outcome of democracy. Understood? And in this way, we can say that it provides dignity and freedom to all citizens. Clear? It provides dignity and freedom. Right? It should provide dignity and freedom. And maximum democracies, they do so. Right? So these are the brief outcomes. Clear? Any problem? So this is the way. Now we can say that if anybody asks what is dictatorship, then what will you write? If question comes, what is dictatorship? Right? No dumb question. What is dictatorship? Right? Dictatorship. So what will happen in dictatorship? A system in which power is wasted in single person. Clear? Single person or group of person or group of people, that is called dictatorship. Understood? Dictatorship is a system in which power is wasted, means power is given, if power is involved, right, in single person or group of people. Clear? So we can say that this is dictatorship. Then comes legitimate government. If anybody asks what is legitimate government, legitimate government, then what do you write? Legitimate government. Clear? Means legally chosen government, right? A legally chosen government by people, right? That is called legitimate government. Understood? Legitimate government is a legally chosen government by people, via election, isn't it? You may write also via election. One more word you can add. Clear? Then comes a new term, transparency, isn't it? If anybody asks, transparency. Clear? Transparent, you know very well, right? A material through which light can totally pass. That is transparent medium. You know, physics you have studied. clear? So to examine the process of decision making, right? Transparency means in which process of a system, in which process of decision making, decision making we examine. Here, transparency is a kind of system in which process of decision making be examined. Means how decision was made, you can examine it. Understand? You can ask, you have RTE, right to information, RTI. Clear? So RTI, you can examine the process of decision making. Any decision made, you can examine it. Clear? Very easy. That is called, you know, transparency. Right? So if anybody asks, which form of government is better democratic? Is better democratic or non-democratic? Which form of government is better? Democratic or non-democratic? Democratic. Hai na? What is meant by transparency? If it comes, right? Means to examine the process of decision making in a democracy is known as transparency. Right? A system in which process of decision making be examined in democracy, we will write. Na? In democracy, one more you can also increase. Clear? In democracy. Right? So this is your transparency. Then he may ask, why is democratic government better than other alternatives? So I have already told 5 points. You may write. Clear? Which form of government is considered best? If it comes, which form of government is considered best? Democratic is simple answer. Right? If anybody asks, when is democracy considered successful? Explain. If this question comes, when is democracy considered successful? Democracy come, when we will say that democracy is successful? When do we consider that democracy is successful? Clear? So what will you write? When do we feel that democracy is successful? A democracy is considered successful because the rulers elected by the people must take all major decision, right? So mostly what happens, the rulers elected by people, they must take all decision, not others, isn't it? You will write that. So what will be question? When is democracy considered successful? Right? When is democracy considered successful? Right? Explain. Clear? It will come up 3 marks. Then how will you write according to marking scheme? Clear? Democracy is considered to be successful because the rulers elected by the people, right? The rulers elected by people must take decision. Not others. Understand? Then democracy is successful. Right? Must take all major decisions. Must take all major
decisions. Clear? Means the rulers elected by people must take all major decisions. Then your democracy is successful. Clear? And second, the election must offer a free choice and opportunity to the people. The election must offer fair choice. Right? The election must offer fair choice, fair and free choice. Right? Fair and must offer. You can say free choice. And opportunity. Free choice and opportunity. Clear? To the people. To the people. This is third point. Understand? Second point was that means what happens? The election must offer free choice and opportunity to the people. Understand? Means there should not be any charges for election, for getting vote. Understood? And third, the choice should be available to all the people based on political equality. Clear? The choice should be made to all the people. Clear? The choice should be made to all the people. Clear? Based on political equality. Based on political equality. This is exact answer. Political equality. In this way you have to write for 3 marks. Understood? It comes. When is democracy considered successful? Explain. Then you have to write all these answers. Clear? Yes, sir.